Glock, no safety. Nothing you do can have me shook or faze me. I stay strapped like a dyke bitch, Dick Tracy. No second guessing when I put 10 on 20. My goons, they waiting for you like that new iPhone. They will bury you, swearing everything I own. Real bitch, you can never be my clone. Leave you bloody, massacre, like Al Capone. Louis bags and 100 racks. Trap life, bitch, I body that. Cut it by my team, we off the map. Different states, white powder with a loaded map. Louis bags and 100 racks. Trap life, bitch, I body that. My team, we off the map. Different states, white powder with a loaded map. Bartica, Leah Javinci, 2015, we about to take over this shit, nigga. Hey.
All right, y'all, and we're back. It's your girl, the Robin H. Got juice? I got some more juice for y'all. All righty, and as I did say earlier, Muhammad Ali did pass this weekend. He succumbed to a respiratory failure, if I'm not mistaken, after dealing with Parkinson's disease. And if you don't know who Muhammad Ali is, under a rock, not the word, you just out of there. So right now they're saying that Muhammad Ali is to be eulogized by Bill Clinton, Brian Gumbel, and Billy Crystal. The Huffington Post is reporting that Muhammad Ali's funeral is going to be quite a public spectacle with a host of guest speakers, and it will take place in the hometown of Louisville, Kentucky. They will honor the former boxing champion on Friday with a procession through the Kentucky city and public funeral at a sports arena, with a tribute befitting to a local hero who achieved global stature as a humanitarian. The public service for Ali, one of the most celebrated figures of the 20th century, whose death brought accolades from around the world, will feature eulogies by former President Bill Clinton, broadcaster Brian Gumbel, and comedian Billy Crystal. Family spokesman Bob Gunnell said on Saturday. The procession will then proceed along the city's main streets, including Muhammad Ali Boulevard, to Cave Hill Cemetery, passing locations that were significant to the former champion. The funeral service was scheduled for 2 p.m. at the KFC Yum Center, which seats more than 20,000 people, and will be live streamed at the center's website. So, of course, I will be looking at that coverage. That should be a very, very interesting funeral, if nothing else. It should be very powerful and very emotional. So, of course, let's take a brief moment of silence. Rest in peace to the greatest there ever was that I know of. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. The late, great Muhammad Ali. Okay, and of course, since we had to rest in peace, try to rest in peace. Now, I don't want to say this one. I don't want to say this yet. Let me say this for my last rumor of the day, because that's something I do want to look at. But here is something that's crazy. Also courtesy of Bossip.com, because y'all know I love my Bossip. Gilbert Arenas blasts Laura Gavain and their children on heated phone call. F you and them kids. Well, the Breakfast Club played audio this morning, alleged audio of Arenas cursing on Govan, where he got so intense he yelled, "Fuck you and them kids." The audio was from April 23rd, and Gilbert Arenas did get Donkey of the Day from Charlamagne the God. In the meantime, Arenas appears to have custody of her kids this week, because he's been posting them all over the Instagram. Keep in mind that Gilbert Arenas did just win a lawsuit for defamation of character against Laura Govan, and that was a $3 million win. So I don't know if she has to pay up or they drive. I don't remember what happened, but I do know he won a lawsuit, defamation of character lawsuit. She was saying that he had given her an STD she couldn't get rid of, all this good stuff. You know, he cheated, he did this, he did that, he did this. So, you know, it's just unfortunate that this had to happen. The sad thing is, you know, people forget these kids do go back and see this stuff. When they get older, the internet's still gonna exist. So it's a sad day for you to hear your parents tell your mom, F you and them four kids, you know, because if you one of the four, daddy saying F you. So pray for the Arenas Govan family, because it's just a horrible, horrible thing. And then the kids are involved in the middle of it too, so it makes it even worse. Then here's another story also of Bossup.com, and this comes to us if you are a Harry Potter fan. I'm a Harry Potter fan. I didn't know this was happening, so let's get to it. Let's get to this. This is interesting. J.K. Rowling calls out racist critics over Black Hermione in new Harry Potter play. Yes, that's it. J.K. Rowling is standing strong in her support of the casting of Noma Dumzwini as the adult version of Hermione in the new Harry Potter and the Cursed Child play. The production, which has broken records by selling 175,000 tickets in 24 hours, is tipped to be the theatrical event of the year. But the Harry Potter creator criticized those who have suggested that Hogwarts Studios heroine could not be played by the Olivier Award-winning actress Noma Dumzwini. With my experience of social media, I thought that idiots were going to be idiots, she said in an interview. But what can you say? That's the way the world is. Noma was chosen because she was the best actress for a job. She then goes on to say, I had a bunch of racists telling me that because Hermione turned white, that is, lost color from her face after a shock, that she must be a white woman, which I have a great deal of difficulty with. But I decided not to get too agitated about it and simply state quite firmly that Hermione can be a Black woman and with my absolute blessing and enthusiasm. Cool thing is, I love Harry Potter, and I always wonder what would happen if they would mix up the characters when it comes to being an African American or a woman of color for Hermione, even with I can't think of that professor's name, the older white lady, you know, even with her character, you know, even Professor Dumbledore. What if Harry Potter was Black? You know, when more people actually have gotten into the Harry Potter, people of color, put it like that, because I'm a pothead. That's why I call myself a Harry Potter pothead. No pun intended for those who know me, but I am a Harry Potter pothead, which means that if a Harry Potter movie comes out, the book comes out, I will look, read, watch, whatever. And thank you to my college roommate, Angela Captain, for telling me about Harry Potter, because if it wasn't for her, I would have never picked up a book, let alone got into the series. So thank you, thank you, thank you to Angela. And the last story of the day. I don't know how I feel about this, only because I root for love. I really root for love. But let's see what's going on. It's a wrap. Love and Hip Hop Atlanta's Tammy Rivera and Waka Flocka split. After a number of years together, married couple Waka Flocka and Tammy Rivera are apparently over. Earlier, Tammy shared a cryptic Instagram post about losing someone. And she put on here, not everyone you lose is a loss. Unless it's me, then you fucked up. And when a fan noted that Waka is lucky to have her, she replied, Waka was lucky. She has clapped back at a fan who commented on her breakup. I guess, you know, she's in a weird space, I can imagine. You know, you're on national TV and you have to see all this stuff going on. So this is what she had to say. Somebody told Tammy in her comments, we tried to tell you, but what Tammy do? Tammy want to clap back and try to embarrass people for commenting on what they saw. Now you can see that we were right and he was wrong. Now come here and give me a hug, boop, tough love, you better life off ways. And I'll still clap on a bitch over him, is what Tammy did say. Love is never lost or my loyalty as a friend. The fuck y'all think? I ain't one of those girls that's going to bash him or disrespect him or let anyone else do so. We share too much love and respect for that real women shit. So she did say that they are still friends. If nothing else, they're still friends. So I was rooting for them. That made me a little sad. So, you know, reality TV puts a strain on your relationship. You have strains on relationships without TVs in your face all day. And when you see the TVs in your face, then you got to go back and see all the different comments that people have. You know, it makes it a bit much. So we wish them nothing but the best of luck. And that's it. Juice poured over for today. I had a really good time with y'all. I will be coming back with my Got Juice segment in a couple of days, actually tomorrow. And you're tuned in live. Got Juice. It's your girl, the Robin H, signing out. Thank you guys for listening. If you love me, fuck with me and support me. I'm eternally grateful, and I'm out.
I've been so many places, I've seen so many things, I've seen so many faces, been called so many names, kept getting into fights just for staying in my lane. Fights full of adversities, you're real when you can stay the same.
A million years older, and be the one that carries the hood on the shoulder. Now I'm a CEO, call me the owner, and I can do anything that I want.
I know what people thought, but I'd rather be flying high, and I be gone. Can call me Hollywood until my heart and see my home.
Hey, hey,
I'm just see
a little G to the Asia, E to the D, T to the O. Now
tell me what you see.
I'm just ghetto. I'm just me. I'm just me. A little G to the Asia, E to the D, T to the O. Now
tell me what you see.
I'm just ghetto. I'm just me. I'm just me.
When I'm going home, you're screaming, do your thing. Doing commercials now, I'm on the movie screen. And all my fans are going out to buy my magazine.
Cover to cover, I'm being discovered, they love me.
God, in a million years, I'm a blower. And be the one that carries the hood on the shoulder. Now I'm a CEO, call me the owner. And I can do anything that I wanna. They said that I would try so hard to change my way. You can call me Hollywood, I'm in my heart and not the same. Hey, hey, I'm just seeing
a little G to the Asia, E to the D, D to the O. Now
tell me what you see.
I'm just ghetto. I'm just me. I'm just me.
See,
a little G to the Asia, E to the D,
little
D to the O. Now
tell me what you see.
I'm just ghetto. Me.
It doesn't matter what you do,
no matter what you
do, you really always shine right through.
Shine right through.
Who you are is what's gonna get you far in life. It's what's inside. It's hard to hide. It's on fire. Hold on. Because it's time for you to live your life. You know what I believe? I believe life is what you make it.
Never thought in a million.
You determine your destiny. That's one thing I've lived by. And it's so real.
A little G to the Asia, E to the D, T to the O. Now I'm just ghetto. I'm just me. I'm just me.
Thank you.
Yo, 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 what's up? It's your girl, the Robin H. Got juice?